students, look at this picture. What do you see? You see the pictures of some of the food items. Today we are going to learn about food. F-O-O-D, food. Students, do you like food? Which food you like the most from the given picture? Come on students, let's learn some new words and their meanings. Perishable. Perishable meaning is likely to decay. அழியக்கூடியது. Perishable. P-E-R-I-S-H-A-B-L-E. Likely to decay. Evaporation. E-V-A-P-O-R-A-T-I-O-N. Evaporation means the process of turning from liquid into vapor. Food. F-O-O-D. Food means any nutritious substance that people or animals eat or drink, or that plants absorb in order to maintain life and growth. Any nutritious substance that people or animals eat or drink, or that plants absorb in order to maintain life and growth. Our body needs nutrients like proteins, carbohydrates and fats. Proteins, P-R-O-T-E-I-N-S. Proteins means macromolecules formed by amino acids. Carbohydrates, C-A-R-B-O-H-Y-D-R-A-T-E-S. Carbohydrates are the sugars, starches and fibers found in fruits, grains, vegetables and milk products. Fat. F-A-T. Fat. The body uses fat as a fuel source. Fat is the major storage form of energy in the body. We get these nutrients. Nutrients means a substance that provides nourishment essential for growth and maintenance of life. We get these nutrients from the food we eat. If we do not take all these nutrients in right proportion, it results in some diseases. Sometimes we do not preserve the food properly and it gets spoiled. Through the spoiled food also we get diseases. So we need to preserve the food we eat. In this lesson, we will study about spoilage of food and the ways to preserve them, deficiency diseases, balanced diet and kitchen safety. First topic, spoilage of food. S-P-O-I-L-A-G-E. Spoilage of. O-F of. Food. F-O-O-D. Food. Food items like fruits, vegetables, milk and meat will be fresh for very short period. These are called perishable foods and they get spoiled easily. Some food items like rice have long lifetime but they also decompose. The change in the normal state of the food is called spoilage of food. Spoiled food becomes unsuitable to eat. We can notice such changes from the taste and smell of the spoiled food. Eating spoiled food may cause diseases. Come on students, let's find out what are the causes for the food to decay. Once the food items are harvested, they begin to decompose. Food can be spoiled by factors like air and oxygen, moisture, enzymes, microorganisms, light and temperature. First point, air and oxygen. What is the spelling for air, students? Very good. A-I-R, air. And A-N-D, and oxygen. O-X-Y-G-E-N, oxygen. Do you know the formula for oxygen, students? It is O2. When oxygen reacts with food contents, it produces changes in the color and flavor of the food. Second point, moisture. M-O-I-S-T-U-R-E. Moisture means water or other liquid diffused in a small quantity as vapor within a solid condensed on a surface. Moisture keeps the food fresh. When the moisture is gone, vegetables and fruits shrink. Due to evaporation, moisture loss occurs in food like meat, fish and cheese. Evaporation means the process of turning from liquid to vapor. Third point, enzymes. E-N-Z-Y-M-E-S. Do you know what is an enzyme, students? Enzymes are substances produced by a living organism which act as a catalyst to bring about a specific biochemical reaction. Enzymes break down the larger molecules of the food in different ways like oxidation.
Cut the apple. Wait for a few minutes. See what happened to the color of the apple. When you cut the apple, you cause cell damage. Cutting exposes an apple cells to air, which contains oxygen. This triggers the oxidation reaction that causes enzymatic browning.
Browning and ripening. So the food items decay. Oxidation means addition of oxygen.
Microorganisms. M-I-C-R-O. Micro. Organisms. O-R-G-A-N-I-S-M-S. Such as fungi. Fungi are free living in soil or water. Others form parasitic or symbiotic relationship with plants or animals. Bacteria. B-A-C-T-E-R-I-A. Bacteria. A member of a large group of unicellular microorganisms which have cell wall but lack organelles and an organized nucleus, including some which can cause disease. Yeast. Y-E-A-S-T. Yeast. A microscopic fungus consisting of single oval cells reproduced by budding and are capable of converting sugar into alcohol. These microorganisms can grow well in low temperatures They multiply in food and spoil them.
Light. L-I-G-H-T. Light. Light produces color changes and also vitamin loss. Vitamins are group of organic compounds which are essential for normal growth and nutrition and are required in small quantities in the diet because they cannot be synthesized by the body. Temperature. T-E-M-P-E-R-A-T-U-R-E. Temperature. Temperature is the degree of intensity of heat present in a substance or object. Sometimes rise in temperature causes food spoilage. Come on students, let's do this activity. We will classify the given food items into perishable and non-perishable foods.
Salt. Salt is non-perishable food item. What is this, students? Very good. This is sugar. Sugar is a non-perishable food.
Orange is perishable food. See student, this is wheat. Wheat is non-perishable food. See student, this is tur dal. Tur dal is non-perishable food.
Tomato is perishable.
Papaya is perishable food.
Rice is a non-perishable food item.
Effects. E-F-F-E-C-T-S. Effects. Spoiled food are not suitable to eat. They may not be fresh and tasty. Sometimes it will be harmful to consume them. Microorganisms present in spoiled foods may cause foodborne diseases like stomach pain, fever, dysentery, vomiting and indigestion.
See student, this and all some of the spoiled food. If you are consuming this food means you will be affected by stomach pain, fever, dysentery, vomiting and indigestion.
Students, do you know what is foodborne disease? Foodborne. F-O-O-D. Foodborne. B-O-R-N-E. Foodborne means disease carried by or transmitted through contaminated food. Preservation of food. Come on students, let's learn how to preserve food. Preservation. P-R-E-S-E-R-V-A-T-I-O-N. Preservation of, O-F of food. F-O-O-D, food. The process of keeping the food materials for a long time without being spoiled is called preservation of food. Food will be spoiled if it is not prepared, preserved and handled in the right way. There are many methods used to prevent, delay and reduce the spoilage of food. Food preservation methods. F-O-O-D. Food preservation. P-R-E-S-E-R-V-A-T-I-O-N. Preservation methods. M-E-T-H-O-D. Yes, methods. Cultivation of food requires lot of efforts. Nowadays, food cultivation and the crop yielding are decreasing. There are many people suffering in the world without food. So, we need to protect and preserve the food. The following are the ways to preserve food. First one, drying. D-R-Y-I-N-G. Drying.
See students, this is drying method. Drying is the process of removal of water content from the food by drying it in the sunlight. See students, you can see drying of Tudol.
Students, this is wheat. Drying is the method used to preserve grains. Grain drying is process of drying grain to prevent spoilage during storage. Drying is one of the oldest method to preserve food. Since drying reduces the moisture in foods, making them lightweight and convenient to store. It can be easily used in place of other food preservation techniques.
Second method, addition of salt. A D D I T I O N. Addition of, OF of salt. S A L T. Salt. It is a method of adding salt to food to remove water. Example, fish pickles.
Students, this is dry fish. Salt has been used as a preservative for ages and worked to preserve this fish. Salt absorbs water from the fish and salt draws water out of the fish. Salt dries this fish.
While preparing pickles, we have to add salt. Salt absorbs the water content in the, we have to dry this in the sunlight. Then we have to prepare pickles.
Addition of sugar. A D D I T I O N. Addition of, OF of sugar. S U G A R. Sugar. In this method, sugar is added to food. Sugar dissolves in the water content of the food and preserves the food items from spoilage. Example, jam and fruit juices.
Sugar is added to prepare this jam.
Students, do you know why purchasing packed food items we should check the following details? First one, we have to check the manufacture date. Second one, you have to find out the expiry date. Third, you have to find the ingredients of the food. Fourth one, you have to find the energy content in the food material. Come on students, let's find out some of these details in some packed food.
Come on students, let's find out the manufacture date, expiry date, ingredients and energy content in this sunflower oil. Students, this is manufacture date. See the expiry date students, best before 6 months from manufacture. See students, this is ingredients of the oil. This is the energy content of this oil packet.
And students, let's find out manufacture date, expiry date, ingredients, energy content in this biscuit packet.
The manufacture date students. See the expiry date students. Best before 6 months from manufacture. The ingredients students, energy content of this biscuit package.
Freezing. F R E E Z I N G. Freezing.
See students, now we are seeing freezing method. The microbial growth and enzyme activity of the frozen food items can be prevented by this method. Example, fruits and vegetables.
Boiling. B-O-I-L-I-N-G. Boiling. Boiling is the action of bringing a liquid to the temperature at which it bubbles and turns to vapor. Boiling kills the microorganism present in the food materials. Example, milk and water.
Students, you can see the boiling of milk. While the milk is boiling, it kills the germs present in it. See students, now the water is boiling. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. If you are boiling the water means you can kill the germs and then it is safe to drink the water.
Canning. C-A-N-N-I-N-G. Canning. In this method, food is packed in airtight cans so that germs do not grow on them. Example, milk powder.
See students, in this container, milk powder is packed so that germs do not grow on them.
Addition of chemical preservatives. Addition. A-D-D-I-T-I-O-N. Addition of. O-F of. Chemical. C-H-E-M-I-C-A-L. Chemical. Preservatives. P-R-E-S-E-R-V-A-T-I-V-E-S. Preservatives. Chemical preservatives are added to stop the growth of microorganisms in certain food materials. Example, sodium benzoate. S-O-D-I-U-M. Sodium benzoate. B-E-N-Z-O-A-T-E. The formula of sodium benzoate is C7H5NaO2. This sodium benzoate is added with fruits. Next chemical is sulfur dioxide. Sulfur. S-U-L-P-H-U-R. Sulfur dioxide. D-I-O-X-I-D-E. Sulfur dioxide formula is SO2. Sulfur dioxide is added with dry fruits. Vinegar. V-I-N-E-G-A-R. Vinegar. Vinegar is added with pickles.
See students, to prepare pickles, vinegar is added to preserve the pickles.
Irradiation. I-R-R-A-D-I-A-T-I-O-N. Irradiation is the modern method in which food is exposed to gamma rays or ultraviolet rays to kill the bacteria and the fungi. It does not affect the taste of the food or nutritive value of the foods. Example, onion, potatoes. A gamma ray is a penetrating form of electromagnetic radiation arising from the radioactive decay of atomic nuclei. Ultraviolet radiation is present in sunlight and constitute about 10% of the total electromagnetic radiation output from the sun.
Students, do you know why we have to preserve food? Purpose of food preservation. Purpose. P-U-R-P-O-S-E. Purpose of. O-F of. Food. F-O-O-D. Food. Preservation. P-R-E-S-E. FOODPRETION. Food preservation. Food products has increased due to modern technologies. Yes, agriculture practice is abandoned in many places as there is failure of monsoon. At the same time, many people suffer in the world without food. So, food should not be wasted by any means. Preservation of food is important for the following reason. First point, to retain the color, taste and nutritive value of the food. Nutritive value is the part of food quality, is the measure of well-balanced ratio of the essential nutrients, carbohydrates, fat, proteins, minerals and vitamins in items of food or diet in relation to the nutrients required for the consumer. Second point, to make food available throughout the year. Third point, to prevent the growth of microorganisms like bacteria and fungi in the food items. Fourth point, to reduce wastage of food items. Fifth point, preserving food not only protects our health but also makes food available to the people who need it.
Today we learn about spoilage of food, preservation of food, food preservation methods, purpose of food preservation.
Thank you, students.